Fantastic. That was the fastest lap. The fastest lap so far. Well done.
Before we begin, let's have a quick look at those who will be fronting the grid.
Moore,
Verstappen,
and Charles Leclerc.
Well, that wraps up qualifying, but don't worry, we'll be back tomorrow as we head into the Grand Prix. Hello there and welcome back to Imola, home circuit of the Scuderia Ferrari. We expect to see a lot of local supporters in red today. They've all turned out for what we have every expectation of being a sensational event here at the Emilia-Romagna Grand Prix. 3.1 miles of track here at Imola featuring 19 turns, 9 to the right and 10 to the left. Remember that Imola differs from most other Formula One circuits as it's driven anti-clockwise. Let's hope no one forgets that today. The exit from turn 18 will probably be the setup for many of today's overtakes, leading as it does into the longest straight of the circuit and its only DRS zone. Anthony Davidson joins me once again in the commentary box. Ant, it's fantastic to have you with us here today, but I'm curious, as a man with experience out on the track, how do you stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
Well, from the moment qualifying's over, you start to feel the adrenaline in your body build up and the buzz in your stomach as you anticipate the rundown into turn one. It's all a bit like going into battle, and the unknown situation makes you nervous. Those pre-race nerves are a good thing. The day you don't have them means that you don't care anymore. And of course, you have to make sure that all the procedures are second nature to you so that they're not taking up too much of your capacity.
Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting race. Moore lines up on pole position, and Max Verstappen lines up alongside. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Leclerc, Sainz, Valtteri Bottas, and Ricciardo, Norris, Perez, Gasly, and Nobuharu Matsushita, Stroll, Vettel, George Russell, and Zhou, Tsunoda, Ocon, Nicholas Latifi and Mick Schumacher. Mazepin and Antonio Giovinazzi starts from the back of the grid. It's almost time for those five red lights to go out. Then let's see who can prevail today.
Okay, this is the team's home race. We're all relying on you to impress today. The virtual safety car has just been deployed due to a buildup of debris on the track. Drop your speed, our delta is too low and we risk a penalty. Slow your pace, virtual safety car is ending. Maintain your pace until the green flag. VSC ending, wait for green. Charles is in the pits. underbody's taken a little damage. Watch out for it. We've been informed of an incident which has resulted in lots of loose debris on the track. The safety car is being deployed. Okay, slow down, slow down. Okay, let's get ready to go racing again. The safety car is in this lap. When the field accelerates, remember, there is no overtaking until the green flags. Safety. Officials are deploying the safety car due to multiple cars being stopped on track. Mind your delta. Safety car is in this lap. Safety car in this lap. You will be controlling the pace on the restart. Keep it steady until the safety car has reached the pit lane.
Yes, guys, yes! Come on, boys!
That's a race win and your second race win in a row. Fantastic job.
They take the chequered flag then here in Imola in what has been another outstanding Grand Prix. Anthony Davidson, how do you think they were able to set themselves apart today?
Without a doubt, the safety car changed everything today. The key to their success was keeping calm and reacting to the situation quickly. We've seen teams in the past throw away wins because they were too hesitant, but here they were decisive and that's allowed them to take the advantage.
Looking at the podium, you can see that red suit familiar to fans across the globe. A world-class win for a world-class team. Ferrari, do it again. And now let's take a look at the driver's standings. Moore increases their championship lead. So, Anthony Davidson, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
My driver of the day has to be, no question, Antonio Giovinazzi. Such an assured drive from one of the sport's newer stars and a performance he can be very, very proud of.
It's time to check out the constructors' standings. Ferrari continued to extend the gap at the top of the table. Another team that excelled today was Williams, who make further progress up the table. And with that, we wrap up another weekend of motorsport. But with more races lined up, be sure to join us when we come back with more Formula One.
performance out there. I'm sure you're pretty happy with that.
We all underestimated you, didn't we? How do you feel seeing your teammate up on the podium? You had a close battle today, didn't
you? Great. Well, that's everything.
Okay, we've had the new parts come through the fabrication process. We'll have them with us for the next Grand Prix.